Welcome in today's edition of ESPN FC Live. Very special edition. A little later on, we will be talking about the Premier League title race. But first, we have special guest Mark Consuelos with us. We are delighted to have you with us, Mark. Now, obviously, we all know you from being a co-host with Live with Kelly and Mark with your lovely wife, Kelly. We also know you're a long-time actor. You're a dad. It's not like you've got a lot on your plate. And then you go get involved in a struggling Italian football team. Tell us more about Campo Basso and why you got involved.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you. First of all, thank you for having me on the show. It's a big thrill. Got involved with this team a couple years ago. We got relegated to the fifth division in Italian soccer. We had to start from the fifth division. We didn't have a team. We didn't have a coach. We didn't have a sporting director. And we had about 10 days to go before the season started. And Matt Rizzetta, who leads our group, said I think it's a great opportunity to give the people of Campo Basso something that they've had for, you know, over 100 years. And we need to save this team because if we don't do it, nobody will. And we got promoted last year, and now we're in a title race. We're 2 points ahead with 2 games left, hoping for promotion to Serie C, which would be the third division of Italian soccer. I got to tell you, it's been a huge thrill for me.
It's been amazing as well. When I actually look at Serie D, it's like a minefield. There's so many teams to even get to where you have and everything you've done. What's the work been like that you've had to put in to even get there?
You hit it on the head. It's really, there's seven Girone, which are like seven leagues within Serie D. And only one, the winner of each division goes up to Serie C. So usually in other divisions, you know, the top two, the top three, they go up, the top two or top bottom three, sorry, come down. Just one team from this 18 team bracket, spread, you know, seven of those gets put up. But the most interesting thing about this league in Serie D is that you have to play with four under 20 players at all times. So if you sub out an under 20, you got to put in another under 20. So four of the 11 players have to be under the age of 20 years or younger.
Wow, I bet that comes with its complications, but I like
that. Very complicated.
Well.
Yep.
Yeah, it's nice because obviously you're getting those youth players in there. Now, I've got an Italian husband. He's a big Italian football fan, myself included. And I was told when I was going to be talking about Campo Basso that I needed to tell you Molise non esiste, something that you guys have taken on, right? And something that was initially a bit of an insult, but you guys have embraced.
Yeah, Molise non esiste is the region. The region of where Campo Basso is the Molise. It's called Molise. And I lived in Italy as a kid growing up. I never really knew about it. Maybe this is why. This is why. They, you know, Molise non esiste, but they also resist. So I think they like, in years past, they liked kind of being off to the side a little bit, not really having the big, you know, bustling tourism centers. They kind of enjoyed that. But our goal is to make them kind of acclimate to being part of, you know, national news in Italy, which they have made, and hopefully some international news here in the United States. I think that if you follow an English Premier League, even a Serie A team or the Bundesliga or La Liga, you can always have a second favorite team. And so we're engaging everybody to make that second, you know, their second favorite team, Campo Basso, this little engine that could in the fourth division. And we are 2 weeks away from hopefully clinching and moving up to Serie C.
And that's incredible as well. And I hope that all our viewers today will take on Campo Basso and they'll take them to heart as well. So Serie C, and then what's your ultimate goals? Are you looking to go up to B, Serie A in the end?
We have big plans. Our group has always thought big from the beginning, even though it seemed like the craziest idea to start a team with 10 days before the season started and to where we are now. We've always had big plans, big ideas to give the people of Campo Basso, the city, and more importantly, the whole region, something to celebrate. And yeah, we have big plans, but let's just concentrate on getting out of D right now.
Okay, so listen, you said to me that you were growing up in Italy. You've got an Italian mother, right, and a Mexican father. So yeah. Soccer must run in your veins, obviously.
It does.
Must be super passionate about it. Did you have a favorite team growing up?
You know, I did. You know, I grew up in Italy and until the age of five, and my mom was a big Juventus fan. So I always had, you know, Juventus stuff on my walls and my posters. But then when we moved to the United States, you know, back in the mid 70s, 76, 77, you really couldn't, we had three channels, you know, we only had three channels. And then, and PBS had this program called Soccer Made in Germany. And so I would see international soccer weekly, but I'd be, and I fell in love with this team, Real Madrid, because they had a Mexican striker named Hugo Sanchez, number nine. And I wore number nine growing up, no matter what position I played. They're like, you know, I said, I want number nine. And that was my favorite, like, secondary team was Real Madrid.
Yeah, I can get on board with that. Don't you worry. I used to work for Real Madrid TV. Hugo, we like to call him.
Yes.
So let's get back to Campo Basso then and talk a little bit about your involvement, because it's a lot more than just being involved from afar. You've been actually completely, like, involved in this club. You've been dealing with the front office dealings as well. How's that been and why is that important to you?
You know, I've always had a business side of, I'm a creative, I'm an actor, and now I'm hosting a daily talk show, which I find creative as well. But I always had a business mind and obviously a passion for football, calcio. But I never knew the intricacies of what it takes to run a club. And luckily I have good partners that do that as well. I got to tell you, the transfer window, that was fun. Transfer window. We also, 5 weeks, five games into the season, we replaced the head coach and the sporting director. So we have literally rebuilt the team on the run as we were going, because obviously we didn't make some smart decisions to begin with. So we've had to literally rebuild the team and make them in the form that this coach that we currently have, Rosario Pergolizzi, who played with Maradona at Napoli. This is a guy that played with, I love talking to him because he tells me stories about that. But he's been in Serie A. He was a Serie A player. He's coached some great teams. He took Palermo into promotion. And our sporting director, Sergio, that was so much fun to, see who was on the market. Have to rebuild the team on the run, which is not ideal, by the way, and to see the fruits of their labor, helped with us making some good decisions with some good under 20s to be in the position we are now, 2 points ahead with two games left.
Oh, God, we are like this, crossing our fingers.
I got to tell you, my wife would walk into a room, and if I'm speaking Italian, she knows to turn around and leave. If I'm on the phone or on a conference call or on a Zoom, it's like I'm talking football.
But she'll know well as well that all you Italians, always very talking very loudly on those phones as well. That's what it's like in my house.
Gesticulating, yeah.
Yeah, you can't not hear what's going on. You just said that about the transfer window, because this is really interesting to me. Are you trying to convince some of these players yourselves if maybe they're looking somewhere else as well? And how is that?
You know, what was great is that our reputation from the year before of having pulled off promotion with like 10 days left and knowing that, that we were a serious club, and having American owners, I think maybe gave people some pause in the beginning, especially they might've been a little more suspicious to see what we were up to. But we've won over the hearts and minds of the region and of the city for sure. And I think players that are looking to make a change were also interested in what we were doing. And they understood that we were serious about getting this team promoted. And so it's been a little bit easier to get not to have to try to convince people of how serious we are to do the right thing. And we're looking to get promoted.
Yeah, because I think that we see that as well. Obviously, American managers over in Europe still have a bit of a stigma attached to them. It's difficult because they still have a bit of a hard time. But with American owners now, they're getting a lot more respect. What is it you think that they're bringing, or why do you think that they are getting embraced the way they are now?
Well, for, in Italy, it's a little bit less than you would see in the English league and in other leagues. So we saw an opportunity there. And I don't know, we have a lot of Italian Americans in our ownership group. We live, sleep, eat, at calcio. We've made ourselves very accessible to the front office part, our partners there in Italy, with the boots on the ground. One of us is either there all the time or we kind of rotate. So I just got back from Italy. I was there this past weekend, which it was a clinch opportunity for us. We had to win. Aquila had to lose. We tied. They won. So we lost points. So I'm going back this weekend, not to be in the way or be a distraction to the team, but just know that the front office is very close and supports them in every way.
So how can we all follow you and support Campo Basso more? What can we all do?
CBTV on YouTube. You can check us out, Campo Basso TV. We have a big match at Chieti this weekend. I will be there. If we win and Aquila ties or loses, good things we have. There'll be some celebrations this weekend. But we can't control what Aquila is going to do. We're just in control of what we're going to do. And I know the boys are going to bounce back from tying at home. You know, usually we're unbeatable at home. Not that we lost, but a tie, you know, is we need to win. And I know that they're going to be focused and ready for La Guerra, which means war in Italian. And I can't wait. So yeah, CBTV on YouTube.
Okay, we will do that. And we'll say a big in bocca al lupo as well. And we just wanted to say congratulations for the show that you're doing with your wife, Live with Kelly and Mark, because we've just seen the ratings, 2.7 million viewers per episode. The ratings are up and we see the chemistry between you two. Who would have thought, hey?
Well, listen, I'm so grateful that the audience has embraced me to be part of the show. It's such an iconic show. Obviously, you know, Kelly, she makes everybody look good. So I'm very, very grateful that I'm working with someone as professional and, you know, my partner in life. It was a big gamble. We talked about it, like, you know, what could possibly go wrong? And it's gone so right. And I'm really grateful, again, like I said, how the audience at home has embraced me as part of the show.
Oh, well, it's great to watch. And we love seeing you two doing so well as well. And we wish the best for Campo Basso. Thank you so much for being with us, Mark.
Thank you so much for having me on. It's so, so exciting. I'm such a big fan. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. We'll speak to you soon.
Okay.